these words and remember them. For every service that we began with these words in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. It is this name that we place upon your child during baptism. It is that name that we began our service with to indicate that we are children of God. So I pray that when you hear those words, just rejoice and know that I am a child of God. I've been baptized in the water and saved through the blood of Jesus Christ. So we began with those words in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our Lord Jesus commanded baptism, saying to his disciples in the last chapter of Matthew, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And surely, I will be with you always to the very end of the age. The Holy Apostle and the Lord has written, this promise is to you and to your children, and baptism does not save us. We also learn from the Word of God that we are all conceived and born sinful and in need of God's forgiveness. We would be lost forever unless we live it by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who came to suffer, to die, to take away our sins, and have given us the command to go to baptize. Receive then the sign of the cross, both upon the head and upon the chest, upon the heart, as a sign and token that you have been redeemed by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For it is on that old rugged cross that Jesus suffered and died to take away your sins. We invite you, family, friends, and church members, to answer in this dead. The question that I announce and address to this child and to all. Do you renounce the devil and all his ways and all his works? And answer, I do renounce him. Do you believe in God the Father Almighty? And answer, yes, I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. You believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son? Yes, I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence He will come to judge the living and the dead. You believe in the Holy Spirit? Yes, I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. It is in this Christian faith that we baptize this child. It is in this Christian faith that we believe and hope that this child will remain until God's come and called her. Received a certificate, and on that certificate certificate you got the time this child was born, the weight and all of that was on that certificate. But one day you will receive another certificate called a death certificate, yes, a death certificate. But this certificate, it gives this child eternal life. For Jesus said, whosoever believeth in me shall never perish, but have everlasting life. Today, God has worked a miracle in your child by giving her faith, and we pray that she will continue. We pray that she will be nurtured with that faith. Now, I ask you, as parents, as sponsors that stand here, you stand here today to testify that this child has been baptized in accordance with God's word. You stand here today to testify and make a promise that you will see that this child is brought up in the nourishment and admonition of God. I ask you now in the presence of God, will you promise to do all within your earthly power to see that this child entered into the kingdom of God? So then answer yes with the help of God.
Yes,
we pray that you will keep this promise. It is an important promise. Just think, if you don't do your duty, then this child might miss out on making it in the kingdom of God. So I pray that you do the promise here that you made, so that one day we will all rejoice in heaven. We also give you a baptism token. It has three drops of water on it, indicating that this child was baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Place it someplace so she can see it. Maybe one day she will ask, what does this mean? And you will be able to tell her. We give you also a lighted candle, reminding you that Jesus is the light of the world. And as long as we walk in the light, we will never, ever be in darkness. We also pray that you will light this candle at her birthday, this birthday, and remind her again that she is born anew in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now, this is a open for you, the parents, to wear baptism. I pray that you will wear it proudly on your shoulders and say, my child has been baptized. Now may God the Father who called this child out of darkness of sin into his marvelous light, keep her in this faith of her baptism until that day that she marched with all of the saints of God into that new Jerusalem, that number that John saw that no man is able to number. Go then in peace and serve the Lord. Go and make We learn from the Word of God that all men are born in sin. David said, in sin did my mother conceive me. We're born in sin and would be lost forever unless our gracious Lord, as he sent his Son Jesus Christ, the sufferer to die, to take away our sin, to take away this child of sin. Even though she wasn't born yet, when he died on that cross, her sin was there. All of the sins that she would commit the rest of her life was there on that cross. And Jesus takes them away. Baptism gives her the authority and the power. As I said to my servant, every time she asks, Lord, forgive me all of my sin, she is washing away her sins. When sin is gone, we have life and rest. Receive then the sign of the cross, both upon the forehead and upon the heart, as a sign and token that God has redeemed her as his dear child. On the cross, there he died. We receive that on the cross. That's why we place the sign of the cross on the forehead to signify that God will control our mind and our heart, that he controls and own our heart. As we bow now, we pray that he would renounce the devil and all of his works. Baptism is indeed, whether you believe it or not, is an exorcism. Not like what some of you may have seen on the movie, The Exorcist, but it is an exorcist where God in turn removed the devil and claimed this child as his very own. So we thank and praise him for that. It is in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We've gone over the creed, and I'll ask you again, do you renounce the devil and all his works and all his ways? Then answer, I do renounce them. Do you believe in God the Father Almighty? Yes, I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord? Yes, I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord, who was born conceived of our Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sit on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit? Yes, I believe in the Holy Spirit, for the Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of the last. It is in this Christian faith that this child is baptized again. I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Promised that if we walk in the light,
Spirit, bless and keep you in this place now and forever.
Believe in the Holy Spirit. It is in this place.
Son, and Holy Spirit, who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, keep you in this faith now and forever. Lord, keep you in this faith from baptism now and forever. Parents who stand here to make a promise that you would see that these children brought up in the nourishment and admonition of the Lord. We promise here today as you stand in the presence of God that you will do all within your earthly power to see that these children make it into heaven. If that is your desire, will you answer yes in the presence of God? May God keep you in that promise. May you always obey and know that these children are precious in the sight of God. Now may the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be abiding in your heart tonight, now and forever. Amen.
Amen. devil, all of his works, death, question.
To you, renounce the devil and all of his works and all of his ways, and answer, I do renounce him.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty?
Yes.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the triune God, yet one God? Then it is in this faith that we baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
By what name shall this child be called?
Harry.
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 A.
Right.
God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, who created you. God the Son, and Holy Spirit, who have redeemed you by his holy precious blood. And God the Holy Spirit, called, light, and sanctified, and will keep you in this faith now and forever. Amen. Go in peace.
Thank you.
Father, we give you a certificate today, and reminding you that today you have been brought into the family of God, made anew by the power of the Holy Spirit, now children of the Almighty God. We give you a token again here. We pray that you would look at it and remember the three drops of water there, that in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, that you will baptize in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We give you a candle also, and we encourage you to light this candle at your new birth, born again, this day, and that you will sing and pray, happy birthday, because it is a new day that God will wash you. How did that song go? I'm so happy that God washed away my sins today, and that's what you've done for me. Make it less than you. And Father, Father, we pray that you would wear that proudly, knowing that your children have been born in the family of God. Bless you, God. And we bow to Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be it I to live in your hearts and minds now and forever. Amen.
Praise and honor to God.